Coming up on Wave TV, we showcase another easy and delicious recipe.
And we give you an update on one of our students affected by Hurricane Matthew.
Good morning, Somerville. I'm Jelani Moore.
And I'm Alex Egan. Today is Friday, October 20th, and Wave TV starts now. Now Brigman Taylor tells us a little bit more about the PTSA Reflections and how to enter.
Then we check in on Victor Shellhammer 1 year after his tragic incident.
Here at Somerville High School, students are given the opportunity to participate in the PTSA Reflections, showcasing their talent in art, film, dance, writing, music, photography, and visual arts. This year's theme is Within Reach, and all students are eligible to compete up to the national level. The president of our school PTSA, Mackenzie Barrett, elaborates on the PTSA competition.
There are applications and sign-up sheets in Mr. Hamrick's room, as he was teacher of the year last year, so he handles all of the reflections. Basically, you make an art piece, you choreograph a dance, or something to enter in this competition for the theme, and this year's theme is Within Reach.
Best of luck to all competing, Somerville. Brigman Taylor, Wave TV.
Last October, Hurricane Matthew hit the southeast, affecting the town of Somerville and those who call the town their home. Among those affected, one of SHS's very own students, Victor Shellhammer.
We just heard the crack of the tree. We didn't really see where it was or what it felt. And then I just saw Eric come out from behind our shed, and he was like, it hit him. And what he said didn't quite register. I just kind of heard what he said, and I was like, what? And he was like, it hit him. And then I looked over at his dad, and the look on his face was like terrifying, and I knew right then and there that Victor was hit by a tree. He didn't know who I was, he didn't know who his dad was, he didn't know who his sister was. The team came out, so I woke Victor up and I was like, Victor, I said, the team's here. And he like immediately like sat up, and it was like, wait, what are you doing? He didn't quite open his eyes, but he just sat up, which was kind of different. And he was like, kind of fixed his shirt and stuff like, yeah, I got this, I'm good. I'm in a gown, but hey, you know, I look good. And then the team started coming in, and immediately, like, every team member that came in, like, he remembered their name. He remembered what they did, like, how he related to them in one way or another, like, whether they were really good friends or just running partners or whatever. Like, he immediately knew them. I was really happy because I was like, oh, my God, then that means, like, his memory's intact.
Remembering his teammates wasn't that surprising. Running is basically his whole life. Victor has run both cross-country and track for years for SHS. Not being allowed to run was difficult. He was finally cleared to run in January of 2017.
Trying to run after not running, without doing anything for 3 months, it's like trying to run before you learn how to walk. I don't know, all the runners, I've never met like a bad runner. Everybody supports each other, even they're on like rival teams or whatever. Everybody's still like, well, congratulations, you did great, and then they move on.
Victor has been cross-country captain for 2 years. He puts in 100% effort in whatever he does. While the tree was a roadblock, Victor continues to inspire those around him.
He's one of the runners who tries to pull everyone forward. He's the one that you want to be with. He's the one who you want to catch. And he's the person who's the driving force of our team.
Good luck to Victor and his teammates as they start regional competition. For Wave TV, I'm Hannah Simmons.
Seth Marks shows us how to make a good-looking ravioli dish.
Then Allison Padgett talks with former student Jake Stock about how he got successful and his feelings about it.
Jake Stauch, former Somerville High School student, valedictorian in 2009. We are here today to shine light on his accomplishments at being part of the TEDx conference.
Is a company that builds brain-controlled video games to help children and adults with ADHD. So the user actually puts on a headset that we created that measures their brain activity and their body movement and their muscle tension, and they play a training video game that challenges them to focus and sit still and relax. And by practicing these skills, they're actually able to improve their ADHD symptoms. Yes, so currently, if you're a child or an adult and you're having trouble paying attention, the only real way to help you in an evidence-based way is to give you a prescription for something like Adderall or Ritalin. And for some kids and adults, that is helpful. A lot of others, it's not. There are side effects or other issues that maybe make it so it's not helping you. And right now, there are no alternatives if you're having trouble with attention. And what we want NeuroPlus to be is to be that alternative. So if you're having these difficulties, you have a way to improve your attention, and medication can be a complement to that, or this could be something you do before doing medication or instead of. You know, we don't make a judgment there.
And here's a little bit of inspiration from Jake.
Don't wish it were easier, wish you were better. And I like that idea of when you're coming into a challenge, a lot of times your instinct is to wish it were different. And instead you should think inwardly and think, what can I do to be better and be better able to meet this challenge?
Thank you so much, Jake, for letting us have this wonderful experience. For Wave TV, I'm Allison Padgett.
Musical Theater is having a performance in the choir room. Make sure you come by for free pastries and coffee on October 27th at 6:30. Also, underclassmen picture makeups will be held on the 27th, so make sure you dress for success. Up next, Jay Goodrich gives us more about the efforts towards breast cancer support. We sit down with two resilient women to discuss how the devastating disease has affected their lives along with the lives of their families.
Many people are affected by breast cancer all around you, even some of our faculty. Ms. Plain, a breast cancer survivor, shares her experience.
I was diagnosed with stage 3 breast cancer. It was difficult for my daughters to see me go through treatment, and the community and the schools and their teachers and their friends really took care of them. The best thing that ever happened was the whole school rallying around me. They made these shirts. They had fundraisers for me. During Breast Cancer Awareness Month, the halls were all pink and had my name everywhere. I did all of the things right in my life not to get breast cancer. I didn't smoke. I was very healthy before I got sick. In fact, that was the first time besides having children, that I've ever been in a hospital was through my cancer.
Ms. Fuller, the daughter of a breast cancer victim, shares the difficulty she went through during her mom's battle with breast cancer.
My mother was diagnosed with breast cancer 3 separate times, so 2 times when I was in high school as a freshman and then a junior, and then when I was a junior in college. I mean, just thinking of my mom having to deal with it every day, you know, wake up and knowing she has cancer in her body. Trying to be there for her, but also not like talk about it all the time.
Then they explain why and how we should be aware of breast cancer.
Because my mom has breast cancer, I have to get more exams than the typical person. Everything is just all about early detection. So if you know how to self-exam, that's gonna save so many lives, and awareness is just super important.
So the more money that we can put into research and helping these people out, whether when they go through it or helping out their families, is probably the best way to go.
Remember to stay aware, because anyone can be a victim of breast cancer. For Wave TV, I'm Jade Goodrich.
The Academic Awards ceremony is on the 24th of October, so make sure to come out and support your friends. Seniors, College Application Day is on October 25th. Make sure you go to the Media Center to check it out. Make sure to come out and support the Green Wave at home tonight. Kickoff starts at 7:30.
That's all we have for you today. For Wave TV, I'm Jelani Moore.
And I'm Alex Egan. Have a great week in Somerville and enjoy homecoming.
I've been changed. Maybe I just knew I had to wait for you. Draw a knife and carve a little space for you.